Well, welcome back everybody for June the 5th here on a Saturday. And back on the Corvette, as we mentioned earlier this week in a video when we was doing the 55. Saturday is always our day. We try to get as much done. And out here in the shop, we've had a heavy rain. Alan didn't have to come in today, but I've got a few more lines to make. Got the new master cylinder here. And this line coming down from the master cylinder is done and ready. This one has to be rebuilt. It got crimped on removal. And I wasn't happy when I flushed the line. And I didn't know if I was going to be able to save it or not. But no, there is a small gouge right here. So that's a no bueno. And that being said, the most abused tools, I think, in any man's shop are these culprits right here, and these are tubing cutters. And I have a drawer full of them. And this morning, I was out here, and I've got two of these little 3/16ths. Here's one sitting here. I just got through cutting the end of my pipe, which we're fixing to start bending. And every one of them seemed to have abuse. So this morning, I took apart the one right here, and I put in the cutter, and that's a simple, that's a number four screw through. It fits the blade on the larger ones perfect, little jam nut up behind it, and then I sharpen it as I spin that with this whetstone that I've had for my case knives for many, many years. And that's a smooth side, but this puts a real nice edge. Let's see if you can zoom down here on this. It didn't have any serious nicks, it just was dull. And it makes it real easy. I can zoom in there, yeah. So I've already cut the pipe with the other 3/16ths, but in my venue was sharpening hundreds and hundreds of drill bits that I've got that are dull. I'm gonna end up sharpening them. Let's get over here just a minute to this brake line here that feeds off of the proportioning valve to the left front. And you can see with those bends, this one on my left being the original one, and here's the one on the right. I'm using the old Delta stand here. Do need a fixture table so I don't have to spend a few minutes here setting up and jigging. But I've already got my distance between. Actually, let's back off here a minute. The factory curl, that looks like crud. And I think we did a really nice job on this one right here. And this may have a little tweak down, but I like to have at least another 1/4 3/8. Then if I have to, I would trim this. But this should turn. You can see that's got a little bit more angle. And I'm not going to flex that until I get this in that car, because this is a tight line around that frame. We've done a little, I guess we'll call it Texas Southern Ingenuity. Got this blocked so we don't have any movement here. This is the old line pinned down, so I got a good measurements I can take. And use some of my bead roller. I was actually trying to put this in the bead roller, it's too tight. And this here is just good old number 8. Copper grounding wire, that's what I've always used. I've got plenty of it, and it's almost exactly 3/16ths to the T. So that lets me measure red dot, and now since it's hitting the nut here, this is not short. If this was moved up where it belonged, it's going to be just right. But that lets me gauge this when I roll this around. Now I'm fixing to put some oil on here and roll this bend, turn it, and do the turn up. And then I'll go to the Eastwood flaring tool. Let me get down here to level here a minute. And then we'll put the flares on it. But yeah, these are seem like the most neglected tool, at least in my shop. And this one here, I oiled up good this morning, cleaned it real good, but she cut a nice clean straight line. So happy with that. And speaking of the Eastwood products, I am not affiliated any way with them folks. I love their tube and benders, and I have some other tools. But there in that kit is this deal to also chamfer your tubing. Does a great job even on this 3/16. And then to deburr, excellent tool. And with that 3/16 line, I use an old Jacobs 1/8 to 3/8 chuck. It's easy to hold in my hand. I use this for a lot more than that. And then I've got a small, good sharp reamer here. And then I'll do my final with this. But that Eastwood tool that comes with that kit is ideal. And, well, there goes the Jacobs chuck. Yeah. Let's go over there and mention that. I know you guys probably in the shops have one. And this is a loaner from a good friend of ours, another builder. But I like this because you can roll this around once you put your tube in. And then you jam back around, and there's no way that in the dies here. Let me pull the die out real quick here. When you put that tubing in, that tube has to hit right on the die that you're using, and they make life easy by putting this OP-0, and you pull that handle back, and these in and touch, slide up, then clamp off. But I've got to own one of these, and one day, I don't know, I'll break down kind of like on the lathe. I needed a bigger lathe and end up getting a bigger lathe. And there she sits all covered up. Brian over at Metal Shapers sure did enjoy. Let me get over here and turn around a minute. I think we're about done here today. I got my hands full. Yeah, proportion valve is already on. We're going to cut this thing in half. I like to see how this thing ticks. This is for the dual disc brakes. And you can see I had to cut into the sides to free those lines. So I've been on the car. Probably this is original. And it doesn't have where the plunger comes out like the new one. Actually, the inside cylinder and the shaft come out. And there's a black rubber on the front. Everybody thinks that's a deal to relieve that cylinder. It is not. Only thing that thing does is protects that black cap protects that cylinder. Whenever you have a leak in the line, that proportion valve will shut off the rear or shut off the front. Very good design. I like to see how it ticks inside. Got a good old Delco original master cylinder to go back on, and we're gonna get to rolling on this. Anyhow, Brian showed firing up his steam engine. That was most impressive. I hope he watched the video and can comment. And great crew over there. They're a little intimidating to us because, you know, future, well, in the past, some of them have blown up. But that is from people not knowing what to or how to run those. And hats off to you, Brian and Maria and Matt and the crew over there. One day I'd sure love to come over and help you out when you're sawing all that timber. Joe Pye, I'm still watching him build that little South Bend lathe miniature, and got to hand it to him. That thing makes me homesick for my 36. It is down to the T for South Bend. And then all my other subscribers, Adam over at A-Bomb79, and especially old BC Block 02. Man, that guy floors me with some of the things he does, and I love commenting to him, and we hope he'll comment back to us. And we'll do next week. We'll be back on the 55 as well, but probably won't be till Tuesday. I've got to take care of getting these calipers on, get this car back down off of the stands, and ready to get out of here. Y'all have a great weekend and a safe summer. Come back and see us, Bear's Rod Shop. One last look at the We'll call it the Jerry Marcy Bears, nightmare, I guess. But it didn't take long to set this up, especially I sit around here in this roll-around chair and love these old can't-twist clamps. Boy, they just come in handy as all get-out. If I had figured this right, I could have used the slot in the top here. Oh, the reason we got some plates under here, let me come around. You're going to wonder why I rigged it this way. There's a bow, and we didn't distort this coming off. And so I've got that same arch built in here. And whether it's right or wrong, this gauge says we're right on the money. And we're the same height, same distance between here and in the fold of where it went around angle of the frame. And this hooks up to that portioning valve, and then this goes over to, like say, the left front caliper. Y'all have a great weekend, and hope this on the C3 76 Stingray, when it's in the players list, might have been a benefit on how to bend these lines and put them back in new condition. We're out of here.